for Norwich Boxing, who is Zaiphan Morris. Just finished your training session?
Yes, mate, yeah. And, yeah, a little bit sweaty.
Fight's cut just round the corner, yeah, 20th of November.
Yep. Yeah, not far away at all now, mate, 3 weeks.
What can we expect to see this time round?
A lot more of a well-rounded fighter, someone with more of a purpose, you know, a fighter with more of a purpose. And that's what I've been working on a lot more, and what I've been working on a lot more as well, sort of mentally and physically. You know, it was always a dream of mine to go pro, and now I'm here, I want to kick on and really, you know, make something of it. Not just go through the motions, really make a statement, you know, and that's what I've been working hard on in the gym, and all my trainers have been working hard with me as well. So, you know, November 20th, be there, mate, you know.
It's going to be a big one.
Yeah, huge. A lot of fights on the bill as well, so.
Something I've spoke about with a lot of people in the gym, and have Joe Hearn sort of fighting for his first pro title.
Yeah, brilliant.
A pro title that the promoter of your promoter is the chairman of.
Yeah.
There's always opportunities of titles around the corner for all of you lads.
Yeah, definitely. As long as we perform, as long as, you know, at the end of the day, nobody gets to fight for a title unless they're performing. It's as simple as that. It doesn't matter who's running it or what, you know. Unless you're performing, you're not going to fight for a title. Joe Hearn, I mean, he's been in the ring as many times as me, but yet he's progressed further because look at the performances he's put in. He's performed. He's swept everyone aside, mate. So he's rightfully got a title shot, and can't wait to see him in there fighting for it and winning it. And maybe one day, sort of fairly soon, as long as I start making the same sort of statements, I can fight for the same title and maybe more in the future. Who knows? But that's what I'm aiming for, mate. You know, I'm on it this time, mate. Can't wait.
That's what it's all about. Again, obviously, last time out you got the draw, which is something that you can sort of take and fuel upon, really. When you look at boxing nowadays, a lot of people like to keep that whole undefeated, you know, which you're not defeated, but it's still a draw on your record, like people you like said last time out.
Yeah, no, people like to keep their undefeated record, but I mean, it wasn't so much that I didn't keep my undefeated record or anything like that, even though I haven't lost and I got a draw, it wasn't so much that got to me about it, it was that I didn't perform. If I got in a ring and I performed to my absolute best, I'd done everything I possibly could, I'd train hard and I'd done everything that I know I could possibly do, and then I got beat, there'd be no shame in that. I wouldn't be gutted. Obviously, nobody likes to lose, so I'd be disappointed. But I mean, I wouldn't be gutted, I wouldn't be ashamed about it, because I'd done everything I could. So what annoyed me was that on that night, I was nowhere near the best that I am capable of. I didn't produce it, you know, and that's what annoyed me. I won't be making the same mistake again. Like you say, it was fuel. It's all any experience is fuel for the next time. It's all ammo for the next one. And within 24 hours, I was using it as ammo for the next one. Couldn't wait to get back in there. And honestly, mate, I cannot wait to get back in there. I'm doing the business, mate.
Something that I like to use as a sort of saying is everything happens for a reason. It really does happen for a reason. A gym mate of your own, Ryan Walsh.
Yeah.
Pushed and pushed and pushed for the fight against Lee Selby.
Yeah.
It got made.
Yeah.
He lost the fight, but...
Yeah, but what a fight, you know. He's given the toughest fight he's had in God knows how long, you know.
The opportunities have still come up, obviously, with a lot of perseverance and problems, but eventually it's come around and he's now won the British title.
Yeah, brilliant.
To see someone in your gym walk in with that British title...
Yeah, amazing.
how did that feel, and did that even fuel you?
Of course it does. I mean, he even let me, you know, touch the belt and have the belt over my shoulder. That's amazing. You see that British title, and that's... You hear it all the time, it's like a cliche, but that's the belt that every fighter from this country wants to fight for, wants to hold. And it's with hard work, determination, as Ryan proved, it's possible. Don't get me wrong, he's got bags and bags of talent on top of that hard work, that will, that determination. But anybody who's got that grit, that determination, that will, keep pushing, you can fight for that belt. And that's an amazing belt, mate. And yeah, seeing someone from Kickstop, Ryan Walsh, you know, he's a great fighter, a great guy as well. Seeing him rightfully hold that belt, brilliant, mate. Yeah, well happy for him. I was there to watch it as well, and that was brilliant.
Going back down to like the opposite end of the scale, so you've got people winning British titles, but yourself, you come from white collar background.
Yeah.
If you now had someone who walked into this gym who's 8 years old, 6 years old, come up to you and said, "Look, you've worked really hard, and you've got to where you've got because you've worked really hard."
Yeah.
But what can you tell me to keep me in this gym, you know, give them that little bit of advice? Someone, a youngster coming in this gym, what would you tell them?
I'd tell them to never, no matter how hard things get, just to keep on plugging along. Because no, No, even when you think, oh, this is getting me nowhere. And, you know, we all have days like that. It's just keep on plugging. Every single feeling that is a failure, every single one of them, every single one of them moments where you feel like you're failing, you feel like you've got no more left, every single one of them is a little bit of more strength building. It's all character building. Every single thing that happens to you is making you stronger, is making you better, is making you progress, everything. Even when it feels like you're going backwards. Even if you are physically and mentally going backwards, you're not, because in a year's time, you'll be so much stronger for that. So just keep on plugging on, no matter what. Hard work pays off, always.
Go back to your, I can't think if it's your debut or your second bout. We spoke about a possible opponent for yourself.
Mm.
Both of you sort of working along a mirror, really.
Yeah, yeah. Paul Jones
Jr. He wins a bout, you win a bout, he draws, you draw.
Yeah.
You know, both fighting the same way, it's come from the same backgrounds.
Mm-hmm.
Boy Jones Jr.
Yeah.
Is that still a fight that you is interesting you and still sort of?
Of course it does, mate. Yeah. I'm not gonna sit here and call anyone out. I'm still learning. I'm still relatively speaking a novice. I've still got a long way to go before I've reached my full potential at all. I'm not in control of what I do. I listen to the people that know best, which is people like Graham Everett, my trainers, John, Glenn, you know, Darren. And Grant, I listen to them all, my promoter, Mervyn Turner, they guide me, they know what's best for me, so whatever they say goes. But of course, you know, there's all sorts of fights that interest me, but you look at Boy Jones Jr. and he's living the dream. He started on an unlicensed scene. He's got almost an identical record to me with a draw on his record as well, hasn't been beaten yet. Similar amount of fights, I think he's had one more fight than me. Same way, everything is just, you know, it's scary really how identical it is. And he's a good fighter, you know, but, you know, styles make fights. He's a different style to me. He's tall, he's long, he's quite rangy, but he doesn't seem to fight at range. He seems to fight close.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know, I just think there's something about our styles as well that would really gel well, and it would make a good fight. But, I mean, maybe he's not ready for me yet, maybe I'm not ready for him yet, who knows. But if we keep going like that, we'll probably end up meeting, and I look forward to it. I look forward to fighting anyone, mate, so, but, yeah, it'd be nice.
Looking to the future.
Yeah.
You obviously got your fight Friday the 20th of November.
Yep.
The halls promoted by Shamrock Promotions.
Yep.
Going on from there next year, mm-hmm. the big fight night that's being rumoured and just keeps coming closer and closer, and more and more people keep talking about it. Cow Road.
Yeah.
What an occasion for the city. And
mate, it'd be immense. I always put on it, you know, like get involved with us, you know, because we need the support, as simple as that. Any sport in the world needs support, but especially boxing, you know, it thrives on support. It's what it's all about. That's what brings big fights. That's what brings big shows. So I always say, come on Norwich, get involved. To have a show at Norwich City, that's not just come on Norwich, get involved. That is Norwich involved, you know, that's Norwich City football ground. That's what everyone gets in the sport for, fighting a big ground, big occasion, big fights. You know, we've got Liam Walsh is... He might as well be a world champion. He's going to be a world champion. You know, you look at him, he's immense, mate. So we've got world champions. We've got Nathan Dow, who's a junior world champion. You know, we've got Ryan Walsh, who's now British champion. Joe Hearn, who's now going to be a champion. You know, we've got Sam Sexton, who's been there, done it all, and still fighting, looking for, you know, another crack at the big time. And he'll get there, of course he will. So, you know, we've got big fighters in Norwich, and we just seem to get looked over. So if we would have a big show there with a lot of people and Norwich really behind us, amazing, mate. And it's what dreams are made of, isn't it?
If you got that phone call tomorrow morning saying, right, it's been made, we're now looking at matching you.
Oh, mate, I'd cry. But I mean, even if the show did get made at Carroll, there's no, it's not given that I'm going to be on the show. Mm-hmm. I take it. I don't know. It's not my business. I don't know. But maybe that would be a joint venture between Mervyn Turner, who's done so well with us here at Norwich, you know, and rightly so, he should be involved, and with Frank Warren as well. So it's not a given that I'm going to be on the show even. You know, like I say, I'm still a novice, I'm still learning, I'm still a nobody, I'm trying to be a somebody, trying to get better, so it's not a given that I'll even be on the show, but I'll definitely be there, mate, you know, whatever, and I'll still be probably just as excited as if I was fighting on there, because what an occasion, you know, so... Fingers crossed that it does happen, and fingers crossed again that I'd get on the show. But again, like fighting for titles and like progressing, I've got to perform to be able to even get my name in the hat of being on the show. So, you know, November 20th, I'm performing, mate. You know, simple as that. I've got no choice. I've got no choice, and I'm going to fight like a man with no choice. I fought tooth and nail to get to this position, to be a professional. I'm now 4 fights unbeaten, mate. So it's time to, you know, never mind 4 fights unbeaten, never mind you're just a pro. Make myself a name. Keep pushing on, mate. More.
There we go.
Hard work pays off always.
Words from Zaiphan Morris.
Yeah, nice one.
Fight coming up Friday the 20th.
Friday the 20th. Please, the more we got there, the better. Be there. I'm looking to come back with a serious bang. You got Sam Sexton. You got Joe Hearn fighting at the top of the bill, fighting for his first professional title. Billy Bird's back. We're all on there. Craig Poxton. He's going to be fighting for an English title. The fight after this one. Congrats to him. And you'll see what he's all about on this show. So get there. Forget November 5th fireworks night. It's November 20th. Be there. Oosh.
Brilliant. Thanks for your time.
Nice one. Cheers.